In this video, we're going to talk for a moment about the mechanosensory hair cells. And the hair cells are the sensory receptor cells of the inner ear, and they're actually responsible for receiving and processing several different types of sensory information. So they are actually the sensory cells involved in hearing, which is sensed and processed by the cochlea. Hair cells within the cochlea. And then the hair cells are also found in the vestibular apparatus, which is a combination of the semicircular canals and the otolith organs. Now, the semicircular canals actually provide information about movement of our head in three planes, right? And this is really all about head proprioception, sensing the position and movement of our head in space. And those semicircular canals, the hair cells within those provide information about movement of our head in three planes, while the otolith organs provide information about acceleration, as well as position of our head relative to gravity, or in other words, essentially tilt of our head. Now, these are mechanosensory cells because they're sensing physical distortion. In other words, forces are being imposed with filters in the cochlea or the semicircular canals or the otolith organs, specific filters, which allow the hair cells to be distorted, specifically the hairs of the hair cells, to generate a receptor potential and eventually sensory neuron input to the CNS. Now, if we look a little bit closer, we can see the mechanism of this mechanotransduction, in other words, how we transduce a physical distortion of the cell into an electrical signal. And what we have are these stereocilia, these long, relatively stiff cilia, and they're attached to one another by these connecting protein filaments here. And those protein filaments are actually sort of tied to membrane channels at the tips of the stereocilia, and we can see that we're going to end up with some potassium flux here. And all of them, if you look at them from the top over here on the right, you can see all of our stereocilia, the open circles, are adjacent to this kinocilium all on one side. And we're going to get bending either toward or away from that kinocilium, and that's going to be cause either stimulation and opening of channels, depolarization, or when you bend away from that kinocilium, you're going to get inhibition and less depolarization. Now, strangely enough, our depolarizing flux is caused by potassium, right? That's odd. And that's true because hair cells are in all of these locations over here on the left are always found, the hairs of the hair cells are always found in a solution called endolymph. And endolymph is a very strange extracellular fluid. It is very high in potassium and much lower in sodium, opposite of normal. And so in that case, potassium can carry our depolarizing flux as it enters the cell, going down its electrochemical gradient. That depolarization will cause opening of voltage-gated calcium channels, which of course would enter the cell. That calcium causes neurotransmitter release, which of course then binds to our sensory neuron, to generate action potentials along that sensory pathway. Again, conveying information about either hearing, movement of the head, acceleration, or position of the head, depending upon which hair cells are being activated. Now, the receptor potential, as we can see here, matches up with that bending, right? Bending of the hair cells. If we bend toward the kinocilium, we get depolarization. If we bend away from the kinocilium, we get hyperpolarization. And of course, that gets converted into increased action potential frequency or decreased action potential frequency in the sensory neuron, conveying that information to the CNS.